to everybody, in microwaves, from a microwave oven to discover their effect upon them.
The purpose of our project is to find out the effect of microwave radiation during the germination of a seed. The method of conducting the study was microwaving organic ATP seeds for 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50 seconds and monitoring their growth over a course of 5 days.
Considering that microwave radiation has the potential to increase the rate of germination, this could be applied to the farming industry on a global scale, since the farmers could use this method to germinate seeds.
The waves are not ionizing. It must be hypothesized that they will not affect the molecular structure of the kidney beans. Instead, the physical structure of the kidney beans will be affected by the microwave radiation.
It's theorized that the heat from the microwave oven will allow the microclouds of the beans to expand, therefore absorbing a greater volume of water. So it's hypothesized that the beans microwave for the longest period of time will absorb more water, therefore having the fastest rate of growth.
The materials used in this project were
60 organic kidney bean seeds with detected coats, no cracks, no bumps, no dents, no discoloration. A syringe, 60 Ziploc bags labeled with replicate numbers and seconds, and a roll of black plastic.
We also used an electronic balance, tap water, microscope, microwave oven, one bowl, one camera, and 10 paper cups cut in half, labeled with replicate numbers from 1 to 10.
Coming to the procedure, first we observe all the beans with a microscope to ensure that there are no cracks on the circuit. Then we zero the scale and place a bean on top of it. We record the weight. We do this for all the beans. We also observe the physical properties before we microwave the beans. Then we take a paper cup and we take the beans which are to be microwaved for 10 seconds and we place them in the microwave. After that, we record their weight after microwaving. We place the beans into their corresponding Ziploc bags and we do this for all the beans, also for the ones which are to be microwaved for 20, 30, 40, 50 seconds.
Fill a bowl with tap water and measure 8 milliliters of water into a syringe. We press the end of the syringe onto the paper towel. Obtain an bean seed and wrap it in the wet paper towel. Then place it onto its corresponding Ziploc bag. Repeat those steps for the next day. Measure the length of the radical and roll it to statistical tilde to the end of the radical using a piece of black plasticine. Mold the plasticine into the shape of the radical and measure it using a ruler. Observe and record the length of the radical from where it is attached to the tilde to the end of the radical. Observe and record the physical properties of beans. Observe and record the length of the radical points attached to the tilde. Take photographs of the beans. Repeat those steps every day for 5 days and ensure that you add 4 milliliters of water on the second day and 2 milliliters of water on the fourth day.
During this experiment, we had some general observations which were the trends that we noticed, such as
when the at the lowest rate of growth. It was seen that about half of the beans that were microwaved for 40 seconds had the radicals emerge, while only one bean microwaved for 50 seconds had the radical emerge. Imbibition proceeds at a faster rate when the seed is exposed to greater temperatures. The micropulse, higher temperatures will allow the micropulse in the beans to expand, making them absorb a greater amount of water, therefore speeding up the germination process.
The beans microwaved for 10, 20, and 30 seconds germinated before the control group. The beans microwaved for 30 seconds had the longest rate of growth because they received the ideal amount of heat, which allowed the prime volume of water to be absorbed. Majority of the beans were buried for 40 and 50 seconds, not germinate because of excess water. Since they were exposed to a lot of heat, the macrophages absorbed too. The macrophages expanded too much, so it absorbed too much water. So the heat plus the excess water all contributed to the stunt and inhibit of the beans.
During the experiment, we evaluated that since the end of the rifle was such that it could not inhibit by the seed, only the visible portion of the rifle was measured. This affected the experimental results because the actual length of the rifle was not obtained, and the seed coat couldn't have been peeled off as it could have interfered with the growth and maturity of the bean.
The beans should be roughly the same age and health so that they can react equally to the microwave treatment. They should be young and healthy so that they can withstand the heat and radiation of the microwave to a greater degree.
After conducting the experiment, we concluded that when the beans are microwaved, they gain an increase in temperature. This allows the seed coat to imbibe a greater amount of water than the seed that has not been microwaved. This can be explained by the fact that the micropile of the beans expand, making it absorb a greater amount of water because of heat.
Our hypothesis was proven correct to a certain point. Only the question said that the beans microwaved for the longest period of time would have the fastest rate of growth, since the beans microwaved for 40 and 50 seconds did not germinate that much. Based on the experiment, the beans microwaved for 30 seconds in a microwave operating at 2.45 gigahertz and 900 watts had the most successful rates of growth based on the length of the radical since compared to the other beans. This experiment is not only useful for the farmers but also for people who like plants. For example, the students could use this method and apply it in experiments and trials.